We're back at Sun Valley, and the next to skate in fourth place entering the free skate here is 17-year-old Lisa Urban. And she's skating to music from the movie Spartacus.
Lisa is competing for the very first time with her new coach, Evie Scottfold, and they planned a very conservative program. Double axel into the shadow. When you're jumping from sunlight into the shadow, you lose your depth perception, and it's really hard to figure out where to put your foot down.
Lisa Urban, now 17 years of age, and this is a very important season for her, kind of a rebuilding season.
Triple toe loop, double.
1993, she finished second in the U.S. National Championship. She dropped all the way to seventh last year, and that prompted a switch in coaches from Carol Heist Jenkins to Evie Scottfold. It was, I think it should be said, a very amicable split. The relationship with Lisa Urban and Carol Heist Jenkins remains strong.
Her next jump, a relatively easy one, a double lunge. She'll reach back with her right foot and vault, two turns in the air. In order to compete on this level, you need triple lutzes, not double lutzes. A double axel. Couldn't control the landing. It looked like she got a little more height than she knew what to do with. This ice is very springy. You can really see where the stamina is starting to diminish. At the end of the program, your shoulders start to come up, your legs don't quite get the same push they did at the beginning of the program. And it's, everything seems to happen in slow motion. If you want to save a jump, your legs just aren't quick enough to get back underneath you if you have a problem.
Lisa Urban, who's now a senior at Dennis Yarmouth High School in Cape Cod, Massachusetts.
Well, if you've ever played catch outdoors, you know how tough it is when that ball is in the sun and all of a sudden it's in the shade and you're supposed to catch it. Well, it's the same with ice skating. all of a sudden it's a little darker, you can't see the ice quite as well as you can in the sun, and it's tough to find a way to put your foot down. If you just don't see the ice as well when you're going from light to shadow. Very difficult.
Well, an old-fashioned way of presenting the marks, these young ladies are called caddies, and they skate out and give the marks.
4.8.
And here are the first set, 4.8.
4.9.
5.0. 4.8, 5.0, and 4.9.
It's tough. You cannot hold back anything when you're in the wind and when you're in the sun and when you're outdoors. You've got to go for everything 100%. And these conditions mess with your head. They make you doubt things or muscle things or go for things or back off. And it's very, very difficult. It takes a lot of experience to be able to skate well outdoors.
And the marks for presentation, Scott.
These are a little bit better. You know, she really didn't have the technical merit that she needed to get the higher marks. And, you know, the 5.2s are okay for that program.
When we return, the leader, Michelle Kwan. U.S. Ladies Outdoor Skating Challenge at Sun Valley. Three ladies yet to compete. Tanya Kwiatkowski now in third place with her coach, Carol Heiss-Jenkins. Nicole Bobek with her latest coach, Richard Callahan. Nicole is in second place behind the country's top-ranked amateur, Michelle Kwan.